Hello students, we are going to start with class 9 chemistry chapter 1, that is matter in our surroundings. Matter, first of all let us define it. Anything which occupies space and has mass is known as matter. Matter, for example, you can take air, water, this camera, this marker, this board, everything around us is nothing but matter only. Matter is made up of tiny particles, say atoms or molecules. We can take one example of raindrops. A raindrop, it is such a tiny raindrop. Instead of that, it itself consists of 10 raised to 21 particles. Now we'll see characteristics of particles of matter. See, characteristics are the features. We'll see four characteristics. The first one is particles of matter are very very small. This we can show by an experiment. This experiment is known as dilution experiment. See, I am drawing over here. We'll take, this is 5 beakers. This is the first beaker, which consists of 100 ml of water. It contains 100 ml of water. Mark it over here. Another beaker. Mark it as second beaker. This consists of, it contains 90 ml of water. This is third beaker. In this also we will add 90 ml of water. Similar way fourth and fifth beaker. Each one which are all of which contains 90 ml of water. Now what we will do, from the first beaker we will take 10 ml of the solution. Before that, in the first beaker we will add few drops, or let us take 2 drops of ink. 2 drops of ink solution we'll add over here. We'll see the solution becomes bluish in color. Now from the first beaker take 10 ml of the solution into second beaker. Similarly, from second beaker add 10 ml in the third beaker, similar way in fourth and fifth. This process is known as dilution. And what you will observe, we will observe that in the first beaker the blue color was, it was dark blue color. As you will go on diluting it, the blue color will get lighten up, but it will not disappear. Even in the last beaker you can observe a lighter shade of blue color, but it will not disappear, which shows that the particles of matter are very very small. This ink drops, they itself consist of particles which got split up to show the color even in the fifth beaker. Now we'll move to the second one. Second is particles of matter have spaces between them. Now see, for this also we can show it by an experiment. We'll take one beaker, add about 100 ml of water in it, mark the level of water in the beaker. Now add around 50 grams of sugar in this particular water and stir it properly so that this sugar gets dissolved in it. Now even after the sugar is getting dissolved in it, we will observe that the water level which is up to the mark will not rise. So where has that sugar gone? It is obviously inside the water molecules, okay? And these water molecules, it shows that they consist of spaces between them in which the sugar molecules will get inside that properly containing it. Then the third one is particles of matter are constantly moving. This is the third characteristic. See, if you light an incense stick at one corner of the room, the entire room will get fragrance of the incense stick. Similar way, somewhere very far off some food is getting cooked, then you can smell it from a far off distance as well. It is through what? It is through the same characteristic, that is particles of matter are constantly moving. One more point to be noted over here is that when you heat the matter, then that is on increasing temperature, heating, that is the temperature is increasing, then the kinetic energy of the these particles will increase and they will move more faster. Ke means kinetic energy, which is the energy associated with the motion of particles. Then fourth one, the particles of matter attract each other. This also we can prove by one example, but before that one more term is there, see, cohesion. As I told you, the particles of matter attract each other. Cohesion is the force of attraction between the particles of matter which binds them together. See, let us take one chalk piece, one ice cube and one iron nail. Beat all three of them with a hammer. What you will observe, the chalk will get split up into its pieces very easily. Lesser force we have to apply in case of chalk. Whereas in case of ice cube, you have to apply a little bit more force to break it up. And in case of hammer, whatever force you apply, it will not get broken up into its pieces. So that shows that there is difference in the force of attraction between all the three substances over there. And in out of chalk, ice cube and iron nail, which will have the highest maximum force of attraction? The iron nail, okay? And a chalk will be having the minimum force of attraction, okay? So that's what, these are the four characteristics of particles of matter. Our next topic is classification of matter. Now see, modern day classification of matter is based on either physical properties or on chemical properties. On the basis of physical properties, the matter is being classified into three: solids, liquids and gases. On the basis of chemical properties, matter is being classified into elements, compounds and mixtures, which we are going to study in the higher classes. So now in this chapter we don't have to study this. We'll see now solids, liquids and gases in detail. Diagrammatically I have represented it over here. Each sphere represents a particle. You can see in case of solids, the particles are tightly, closely packed. In case of liquids, you can see the particles are not so tightly packed. There are some spaces between the particles. And in case of gases, the particles are far apart. Lot of spaces are present between them. Now, we can say that these solids, liquids and gases are being classified on the basis of two very important factors. One is IMF. IMF is intermolecular force. Again I repeat, intermolecular force. And IMS. The second factor, IMS is intermolecular space. Molecules, now you just understand the particles. Already I told you in the beginning that matter is made up of particles which can be atoms or molecules. So this intermolecular means, inter means between molecules, like interstate is there, between two states, isn't it, interdistrict, interschool. Similar way, intermolecule mean between the molecules. So intermolecular force and intermolecular space. Now you can see here I have marked the arrow towards this gas, which is, this arrow represents that as we move from solids towards gas, IMF decreases. This down arrow represents decrease. Okay. So when you are moving from solids to gases, intermolecular force decreases. Force means the cohesive force, which we have seen earlier, cohesion. And intermolecular space increases. This upper arrow means it increases. You can see over here, force will decrease, so the space will increase. Fine. Also, as the space will increase, Ke. What does Ke represents? Kinetic energy. Already I told you, kinetic energy is what? It is the energy associated with the moving particles or motion. Okay, so kinetic energy also increases. Fine. Intermolecular force decreases, intermolecular space increases on moving from solids to gases, and Ke also increases. Now let us study the differences between solids, liquids and gases. Already we have seen intermolecular force, intermolecular space and Ke. Okay, now on the basis of that we'll see the differences. These all properties are there. The first property is shape. See, in case of solids, shape is fixed. You can take any example. For example, a table. Shape will be fixed. In case of liquid, the shape is not fixed. For example, let us write the example also here. Table. Here, let us take water only. Water, milk, anything. And any gas. Oxygen, nitrogen, anything. Okay? O2 means oxygen. Fine? Okay. So, table, the shape is fixed. In case of solid, the shape is fixed. Liquid, the shape is not fixed. You know, milk, water, any liquid, it takes the shape of the container in which we are keeping it. Gases also, the shape is not fixed. They also take the shape of the container. Then, volume. Volume, in case of solid, it is again fixed. In case of liquid, the volume is fixed. See, for example, if I have 100 ml of water, that 100 ml of water, even if I keep it in a glass or in a bigger container, anywhere, the volume will remain same. It will remain 100 ml only. It will not change to 200 ml or what. Only the shape changes, not the volume. Then, gases. Gas, it is not fixed. The volume of gas is not fixed. See, I'll give you an example. If we have a balloon is filled with some amount of gas, the same gas if we fill in a room, it will occupy the entire room also, and there is no fixed space between the particles of a gas. So the gas particles will occupy the entire room, as well as when same amount of gas you are filling it in a balloon, then that same amount of gas will get filled up in the balloon also. So we can say the volume of a gas is not fixed. Third is compressibility. Compressibility means any substance, how much it is compressible, like a sponge. Okay, so compressibility, solids you cannot compress. You have a table, can you compress it? No. Then liquid, can you compress liquids? No, liquids also cannot be compressed as such. The main reason behind it is intermolecular space. Okay, we know that in solid intermolecular space is negligible, so how can we compress? In liquid, lesser intermolecular space, and in gases, so much intermolecular space is there. So when you compress it, a gas can be compressed very easily, and that is why the examples you have seen, LPG, liquefied petroleum gas, the gas cylinders which we are using at our home, it is nothing but the compressed gas only. Then CNG, compressed natural gas, they are gases which are in compressed form. Okay, this LPG especially, see, it is known as liquefied petroleum gas. It is a gas, but when it is compressed, it becomes what? Liquid. We'll see in detail about it further, but just now you understand gases can be easily compressed. Density, it can be defined as mass upon volume. Okay, so over here, density in case of solid is very high because the particles are close together. Density in case of liquid, it's moderate to high, intermediate between solid and gases. Density in case of gases, it is very, very low. Okay, because again, the same reason, particles are far apart. Then fluidity. Fluidity, you know, fluids which can flow easily. Solids, they do not flow. Can a table flow? No. We can also say it is rigid. The opposite of fluid is rigid. Okay, that is inflexible. Then liquids, very common. You all have seen liquids flowing, whether water, milk, anything. Okay, gases also flow, oxygen, nitrogen, whatever, you can take any example, they also flow. Okay, and the same thing I've written again, I'm telling all these things are due to what? Due to these two important factors, intermolecular force and intermolecular spaces. Now let us study a very important property of matter, which is diffusion. You are going to study this property in many subjects now and then. So let us see what it is. Diffusion, first of all, let us define it. Spreading out and mixing of a substance with another substance is due to motion of particles is known as diffusion. Okay, this is the property of fluids, because you can see clearly it's written due to what? Motion of particles. So fine, and fluids only, the particles of fluids only move. Therefore, due to motion of particles, and so we can say this is the property of fluids. Okay, now diffusion, as you increase the temperature, always remember the rate of diffusion will increase. I'll explain you this with an example. See, in one room, if a person is spraying deodorant, okay, then you can smell the deo in the entire house because of this property called as diffusion. Deo is a gas, okay, and that gas spreads out in the entire house, fine. This I told you, this is the property of fluids. This example I gave you for the gas. You can also take an example for liquids. Simply take a beaker, put some ink, 2-3 drops of ink in it. What you will see? Slowly the entire water will become blue in color without even touching it. This is also what? Diffusion itself. We are not giving any energy, we are not doing anything, then also the entire water will become blue in color. Okay, and if you will heat the water, then the blue color will spread out very quickly. That's what I told you, that as the temperature increases, rate of diffusion increases. In gases also, let me give you one example. If it is a cold food, anything which is cold, then you will not smell it very quickly. But if there is something, if a hot food, something is being cooked on the gas stove, then you can smell it very quickly, because in that case the temperature is high and therefore the diffusion will be faster and you can smell at a far off distance also quickly. Okay, then diffusion is maximum in gases, and in solid it's not there. Liquids also it is there, but relatively with a lower pace. Okay, now we'll see change of states of matter. These three states of matter, which are solids, liquids and gases, can be interchanged by two things, by two applying two factors. One is by change in temperature and the second one is by change in pressure. Okay, here we are only seeing for the change in temperature. Fine, you can see here solid to liquid, this upper arrow, liquid to gas upper arrow, both have written over here heat. Okay, when you heat solid, it will change into liquid. When you heat liquid, it will change into gas. This process, when a solid is heated and it changes into liquid, this process is known as melting. Okay, when liquid is heated, it changes into gas. This process is called as boiling. So we can say upon heating, the state of matter is being changed from solid to gas. Now let us come to this down arrow over here. When gases are being cooled, they change into what? Liquids. This process is called condensation. Okay, you might have seen condensation. If you keep a glass in which some ice is there, then some water droplets get accumulated on the side walls, outer walls of the glass. This is what? Condensation. Okay, this is due to cool. Then liquids on cooling, they will change into solid, and this process is called freezing. You all know water on freezing changes into what? Ice. Okay, so state of matter can be interchanged by two factors. One is temperature and second one is pressure. Temperature we have seen over here. Now there are certain substances which directly change into gases, solid substances. Solid substances which directly changes into gas upon heating, and gases directly change into solid upon cooling. Okay, no liquid stage is coming. This process is called as sublimation. Okay, and let me give you some examples for that. You might be seeing naphthalene balls at your homes. You might have seen which your mummies keep it in the clothes or wash basin, etc. We keep it there. Okay. So those naphthalene balls, kapoor bhi bolte hain hum unhe, those naphthalene balls, they get to converted into directly gases. You have never seen a liquid stage, okay? So they are sublimable substances, camphor, naphthalene, then some chemicals are there like ammonium chloride, etc. Okay? The example of this, that is a gas getting converted into solid, is solid CO2. Carbon dioxide. CO2 is what? Carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide is a gas, and when it is being cooled, it will directly get converted into what? Solid. That's why they are writing over here solid carbon dioxide. Okay? So this process is called as sublimation.